Walking into someone else's still site, I mean, it's strange. I mean, I know how I would feel if someone walked into mine.
How long you been fooling with liquor?
I've been messing with liquor 10 years.
10 years?
I'm appreciative that they were so receptive to me. I know these gentlemen make liquor on another scale.
How you like this little setup?
I don't know, this is the still site.
I brought Richard here because he's very good with fruit. These guys right here, when it comes to a brandy, it don't get no better.
So I've heard.
He deals with brandies and stuff where he's at in Louisiana. Figure we need to get everybody together.
Well, we got this mashed in, and then we got a little something here for a little brandy for the strawberry brandy.
Yeah.
These guys are making a strawberry brandy. I love mixing things up. This strawberry needs a compliment. You ever thought about mixing that with something?
No, not really.
You know, all I can say about folks in Louisiana, they must have a set on.
I deal with a loquat.
Lo who?
Loquat, Japanese plum.
Oh, Japanese.
Well, to be honest, he's naming off stuff we ain't never heard of, much less know what it even tastes like.
What else besides loquat?
Dragon fruit, lychee.
Lychee? You can get them if you go in that creek.
No, this is a fruit. I like blueberries, blackberries.
We've never done a double fruit mash before. We've never mixed.
First time for everything.
So we got to thinking, maybe if we take Louisiana and Virginia and put them together, we might come up with us a damn good brandies.
Louisiana-style moonshine?
In Virginia?
When it comes to making moonshine, Richard does one thing in Louisiana where he's from, and we do a whole different thing here in Virginia where me, Henry, and Kenny are from.
That looks like persimmons.
This is persimmon.
Kenny.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this.
That is Dad, he would take him and soak him in that whiskey. And I said, Dad, then people are not going to buy that crap, man. They about beat the door off of Dad's place down there buying them. They buy all of these before they even touch the strawberries or blackberries or anything.
Get you a hunk of it. No,
yeah, sure. Anyone.
How's that tip?
Sounds good. There we go.
Mm-hmm. That's real good.
Those are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, that is good. Look, there's sweet potatoes.
Now, you know,
I wonder if you could do something with a sweet potato.
We definitely could.
Mm-hmm.
I've done a vodka with a sweet potato.
Yeah.
This is an awesome, awesome vegetable. Hardest part about dealing with this is you have a lot of sediment.
Well, now, in a submarine pot, we don't do that.
You see the way they're designed, it'll roll with the metal. Mm-hmm. It just starts boiling.
Just rolls right around.
It's just like you're staring at it.
I'm in college right now. I'm in class right now.
Yeah,
I appreciate this opportunity.
Well, you know what I did when I first started working with these fellas?
What's that?
I shut up and learned. That's what I did. Hey. I know it's hard to believe I shut up, but I did. I shut up and I learned.
Well, I'm going to zip my lip.
What is all this?
This is awesome. What do you think of that right there?
It's like an egg about to hatch from another planet.
It's called a jackfruit. It's a real sweet fruit right here. Down in Louisiana, there's a lot more fruit-based liquor because there's always some type of fruit growing, as opposed to this area where it's a lot of grain-based liquors.
What does it taste like, isn't it?
Bubble gum.
This is a dragon fruit, very sweet.
I can see that Richard's really in his element here.
Tickle, what do you think about this?
What is it?
A rambutan.
He's picking up fruits that I've never seen in my life, and he knows what they are. He knows what they taste like.
Very sweet, very pleasant.
That like one of them things come out of the ocean?
Hey, that thing will bite you.
No, you bite it. Looks like a grape on the inside.
Look at that.
Tickle was infatuated. He loved these rambutans.
Is it good?
It's real good. It really is. You see all these spines on them and how pokey that is? Could you imagine that coming out of your butt? This rambutan, it was good. But I don't know if that would go with strawberries.
Tickle, don't run.
Uh-oh. Was it sugar cane?
This is sugar cane. This is pure sugar.
That right there, huh? Oh, yes, sir. That's sweet.
Down in Louisiana, we have sugar cane. This is something that I use often. I mean, I would almost take this and put this into a mash.
Wouldn't that be a rum?
Yes. I can use sugar cane as a sugar source without buying a bunch of sugar and throwing sugar in. It's gonna give it a little bit of different flavor.
So we got strawberries, right? What do you think would go good with it?
Mangoes, the yellow mangoes.
The yellow mangoes.
Soft.
I mean, they're soft.
Yes,
they're real
they
soft.
Are.
Yellow mangoes are smaller than the other two varieties of mango, a lot sweeter. The red mangoes, they're larger. They give you more meat. But the sweetness, I look for sugar content. A yellow mango gives you more bang for your buck. That would do real well with that strawberry we're gonna deal with. A little bit of sugar cane in there to give it a little twist.
Mango strawberry rum brandy. Flows right off the tongue. Richard seems to think that the flavor profiles are gonna pair very well with our strawberries, so that's what we're gonna do.
You take care of this?
Did you pay for
you
this?
No, I pay for it.
You said you was gonna pay for it.
You said you was gonna pay for it.
Oh, my.
Thank you, sir.
Strawberry. That's a pretty common one for us. But yellow mangoes, now this is something we have never tried before.
Is this a seed or some sort of core in here?
It's both of what you just said, a seed pod.
What about skin on this thing?
I cook everything.
Can we smell good?
That's really good.
But you know what? Once I give this yellow mango a try, I'm immediately a big fan. And also, when we're mashing in, looks a lot like peach.
You know, I'm getting this good smell right now. I mean, I'm just smelling a perfect compliment.
We'll take this ice cold water. We're not gonna need much because it's such a small run.
Being here in Virginia and being in Louisiana, two totally different things, like just the water sources here, the abundance of water that they have here, how beautiful it is.
That's better water than you're getting out of your faucet in most places.
We got 10,000 springs in the state of Virginia.
10,000.
10,000.
I don't wanna leave here ever.
How'd you become a moonshiner, man? How'd you learn to trade? Family?
I don't have anybody in my family. I had a grandfather that made wine, but
distillation, a whole lot of difference, isn't it?
A whole lot different. I don't know really anybody that does what I do.
You ever do much cooking at the steel site?
Oh, yes. Gumbo. I'll kill a rabbit in a heartbeat. Squirrel, yeah.
That's what gumbo is, isn't it? Everything that you can possibly
anything
get
that you can think
in.
Of.
I'm a big fan of cooking at the steel site.
You have to be.
Damn, that looks good, don't
it? Yeah, it ought to ferment nicely.
What about that sugar cane?
I'll show you what we do with this right here.
All right.
We'll boil this with the skin on. Get everything out of it. It will start to loosen up these sugars in it.
Richard starts breaking it down into chunks.
Throw them over in there.
I'm really excited about using this and seeing how it turns out.
Oh, that looks good.
It's that mango.
Yes.
That's what we're looking for. We're taking this mango, the strawberries. We're going ahead and sticking it in there.
Get all that goodness out of that bucket right there.
Pour some in here. We'll take that sugar cane, get that poured in. All right, Tickle, I guess we're ready for some sugar, aren't we?
That's real sweet. You sure you want to put some more sugar in there?
I always like to add a little sugar to ours. That brings that flavor out. Throw just a bit of sugar with it. We're dissolving it like we normally do. Just trying to show Richard different ways that we do it. So we'll let this sit a minute, get it broken down real well before we pour it in there.
Yeast can work with that easier than it can work with anything else.
Good deal.
Yeah, that smells good, dude. All right.
Ah, dang, boys.
Oh, that goes really good together.
Now the magic about to happen. It's a special blend just for brandies.
So this is a proprietary yeast you use just for brandies?
Yeah.
We got a combination blend of yeast. Stir that on in, Kenny.
I can smell it.
I can smell it, man. Mm. Coming here to Virginia and bringing some of Louisiana with me, I mean, I think this is going to be a real good outcome, the way we mix this together and put some Louisiana love and some Virginia love into it.
Yeah, I reckon it's time to run this, right, Richard?
Can't wait to taste this.
Right.
We got the strawberry mango mashed down 2 days ago, and I'm hoping it's gonna turn out right.
Let's see what we got. Oh,
nice, yeah, clear
good.
That to me.
Mm-hmm. Pretty strong. All right.
Bitter.
Yeah, hey, she's ready to roll.
Oh, yeah.
Let's fire this baby up.
Mmm, goodness. Gotcha.
As long as I've been knowing about alcohol, I've known about Franklin County. The people that I look up to right now are actually showing me how they've done it, how they learned about it. I'm more than pleased to be able to partake in this.
See here now, Richard, 145 degrees, that methanol is coming off. All of it's coming out of our steel before we even cap it.
No throwing heads off in the run.
Right.
Like, by leaving the cap off, these guys get the methanol out. Just the little things that these guys do that they've been through trial and error with is amazing.
Richard, you ever use rye for your paste?
Never use rye.
But you just add a little bit of water. And when that steel gets good and hot and that steam hits it, it's just as hard as a rock. It will not let it leak.
Now, I know Richard is a good moonshiner, but now I can just see him almost like a sponge, just soaking every little bit of knowledge up that he can.
Yeah, the water's getting a little warmer.
There we go. That's a nice looking stream right there.
When this run starts to come out, first thing I want to do is taste it.
That's a little bit higher now. Mm-hmm. When that liquor first starts coming out, I don't like to really taste test it there. I like for it to run through just a little bit. Then you'll start getting your true taste from it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you don't want to be eating on that.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Richard. Yeah. Give you the first shot at it.
Oh, yeah, that's good. Oh, I'll take the second try, too. How about that? This is an awesome drink. What do you think of that? That mango comes through there real good.
I tell you what, this is some good, smooth liquor. I can taste the mango on your front and your strawberry on the back.
Mm-hmm. Front and back. Mm-hmm. Who's ever heard of it? On the front side, and the back side, and the side side. All I know is the end.
Mango on the front, strawberry on your back.
Mango on the front, strawberry on your back.
They
so full of shit, it's unreal.
I know Richard's got his own thing going on down in Louisiana, but I sure wouldn't mind if he come up here and run liquor with us all the time.